Welcome all. In this lecture, we are going to learn about vector addition. Now, let us have a look at the two vector, that is A vector and B vector. These two are the vector quantities because there is a arrow over there in both the quantities. These both quantities, that is A vector and B vector, are lying in the same plane. The vector that are lying in the same plane are known as coplanar vector. So this A vector and B vector are nothing but coplanar vector. Now the vector sum of these two quantities, that are A vector and B vector, that are coplanar to each other, is an another vector, that is C vector, where the basic addition of these two vector, that is A vector and B vector, is given as a C vector. Here the C vector is a resultant of A vector and B vector. So, a C vector is resultant of A vector plus B vector. Now, we can obtain this C vector by the help of two ways. First is by help of parallelogram rule, and second by the help of head-to-tail rule. Now let us discuss about the parallelogram rule. Now here is the two vector, that is A vector and B vector. These two vector are in same plane like this. And if we draw a parallelogram associated with these two vector, then it is like this. So here is the parallelogram, and if we want to find out this C vector, that is nothing but the combination of A vector and B vector, then according to the parallelogram rule, this C vector is the diagonal vector. So let us draw a diagonal of this parallelogram. So here is the diagonal of this parallelogram, and this diagonal represent this resultant vector, that is C vector, which is nothing but the vector addition of A vector plus B vector. So the resultant C vector is the diagonal vector of the parallelogram formed by the vector A and B as shown in the figure. So according to parallelogram rule, the diagonal vector or the resultant vector that is C vector is the diagonal of the parallelogram formed by vector A and B. So this is all about the parallelogram rule for vector addition. Now let us have a look at the second rule, that is head to tail rule. Now, according to the head-to-tail rule, if the head of the A vector, that is here, here is the A vector and it is the head of A vector. So, if the head of A vector is connected to the tail of B vector, so here is the B vector, here is the head of B vector and here is a tail of B vector. So here the head of A vector is connected to the tail of B vector, and if this situation happens, then this head to tail rule says that the vector sum of C vector is the vector drawn from the tail of A vector to the head of B vector. So here is the resultant vector, that is C vector, which is nothing but equals to the vector addition of A vector and B vector. So according to head to tail rule, if the head of A vector is being connected with the tail of B vector, then its vector sum will be starts from the tail of A vector and ends the head of B vector. So if head of A vector connected to tail of B vector, then resultant sum, that is C vector, will be drawn from tail of A vector towards the head of B vector. So this is all about head to tail rule. Now let us have a look at A vector. So we have discussed that the A vector is nothing but equals to ax cap plus ay cap plus az cap, and the B vector is also like bx cap plus by cap plus ax, and here is also ax, ay and bz, az cap. So now ax, ay and az are showing the direction only along x, y and z direction. Now if we talk about the vector sum, then its vector sum, that is nothing but C vector, will be equals to ax plus bx that are along x direction. So ax cap is showing its direction along x axis, plus ay plus by along y direction only, plus az plus bz along z direction. So this is how the two vector quantities are being added, and here are the two rules, that is parallelogram rule and head to tail rule for the vector addition. If you like my videos, then do subscribe my channel and please hit the like button. थैंक यू।